Vasu lost it at the labels. Neatly designing, designating the proper spots for the food in the pantry.
What's wrong with a little organization, Joker asked lazily, sprawled on the couch. On the couch Matthew had brought, playing on the Xbox. Nothing's wrong with it.
Vasu wanted to scream. He had thought college would be better. Alfred had always thrown the house into a mess, and the fathers had been in constant battle to avoid the housework, so it had been left to Matthew. Of course, his parents kept the house clean, but not clean enough.
College had been something Matthew dreamed as he collected Alfred's week-old boxers. College where Matthew could demand his roommate to clean and or report him to the campus. College where maybe clutter would be limited to binders and books.
Master's hopes and dreams had been dashed when his roommate introduced himself. Baggy t-shirt, scruffy hair, terrible posture, headphones. Matthew had watched Gilbert carry boxes into the dorm mournfully, shuffling his own few comics into the bookshelf.
And then madness descended.
Gilbert, who was studying to be a veterinarian, was insane. Matthew wanted to try to use adjectives appropriately, and sadly, this was one of those times. Gilbert was constantly cleaning and fixing, following after Matthew in the dorm and picking up after him.
Gilbert would mop the floors every few days, wash the windows, clean the sheets. While Matthew had appreciated and even complimented the behavior, it had started to get too great. Too much of a good thing was still too much.
You can't try and organize the pantry, Matthew tried. Voice nearly not as upset as he would have liked it to be. It's for food.
Gilbert cranes his neck.
Damn it!
Is that your phone? Or is that Dad's phone?
My phone's in my hand.
My phone.
Why is your phone on?
I don't know. No one ever called me. You're in the bad
line. Take your phone somewhere and close the back door.
Gilbert cranes his neck, trying to catch a glimpse of the pantry. You bought 3 instant mix boxes of cocoa because you thought we were out. This way, we can see what we have, what we do and don't have. Trust me, I've thought it all out. He gazed his gaze returned to the center.
Matthew stepped in front of the television, arms crossed. We need to talk.
Gaze flickered between Matthew's face and what little of the television he could see. Matthew could see the wine before it came. Long since familiar with Alfred's mannerisms, Matthew shook his head.
We can't keep this up. Matthew gestured to the space between and around them.
Gilbert's face flushed, and he paused again. Matthew was taken aback. Gilbert was one of those people who liked to bleach his hair white and snicker at anyone who wasn't in his pose.
Posse.
The other man sat up, focusing on Matthew.
Gilbert nodded. You're right. He stood in Matthew's confusion grew.
I didn't know you felt so strongly. I mean, I figured you were fine with how Evan was, considering you just kept doing it. Matthew waved over his shoulder at the direction of the pantry.
And Gilbert, I did not pierce myself at all, no. Ducked his head and looked at his feet. I wasn't sure he looked up, forcing a grin on his face. Well, I know I'm great and everything, but you're quiet sometimes, so I wasn't sure if I should, he coughed, make a move.
I thought I was pretty clear about everything, Matthew almost wanted to thank Gilbert. He hadn't expected this to go as well as it had. More fighting, maybe? A compromise that would be ignored.
Gilbert gave him another grin, but his cheeks were still flushed. Drinks?
Oh, Matthew was having some trouble coming up with an answer. To label the drinks? That just seems more annoying than the pantry, to be honest.
Then there was an awkward silence. Gilbert was staring at him, and Matthew had the irrational urge to wave his hand in front of Gilbert's face just to make sure he hadn't turned invisible.
Sat stretched on.
Matthew attempted a smile. Did you forget how to talk? Had he been Alfred, he would have laughed at his own joke. Hell, had he been Gilbert, he would have laughed at his own joke. It's not really that big of a deal. It would probably...
We don't have to have the labels. Gilbert interrupted loudly. His face twitched to something resembling horror.
The labels were quickly removed by Gilbert himself, and he wouldn't meet Matthew's eyes for a week after the incident. Another few days until Gilbert would sprawl on the couch and call to Matthew as he tried to study.
And then it clicked.
Oh, Matthew said, drinks. Life is good. He muttered as he hugged his stuffed bear. Your bear's not stuffed.